We start with the watercolor. With watercolor, you need water, clean water. So be careful, take it from the tap, not from some river, because that will be dirty and that will discolor your watercolor. It's important to have good paper. Good paper. And sometimes, I don't know where you live, but it's sometimes difficult to get. The best paper you can get is 100% cotton. Nowadays, and that's perhaps more for the regions, perhaps where you live, like India, you have bamboo paper. I use bamboo paper. I love that. Bamboo paper, it's a new kind of paper, and it's very good for watercolor. You can use it for many things. Bamboo is now completely in fashion. You can buy everything in bamboo, even your underwear if you like. But the paper is quite good. Then we come to the brushes, which are also, those are your tools. You have to move with your brush, and that's the most difficult part of course. I have different brushes. I always take this with me. And there are a lot of brushes in, because I don't use them all, but you never know what you're going to do. So, to start with are these brushes. And they are of artificial hair, which is very good for animal welfare. It's specially made. It's kind of nylon, but then, in such a way they manufacture it that it is good for watercolor, because it's important that you get a point and you get a belly. You see, that's important. Also, this metal tube which holds the hairs together is also important, that it's one hole. But you have to get into the water, and then it sucks up the water with your color. And the reservoir, which is the belly, is important, that it don't go immediately down, because then you have to fill your color all the time. So you can buy them in different price levels, of course. It can be very pricey, but it can also be reasonably payable. Then I have a squirrel brush that is made from squirrel hair. And that's not so kind for your animal welfare, but it's a beautiful brush. It's more like the Japanese, Chinese. It's a hair which not really is coming back to the same part, but it gives you also possibilities. So the squirrel hair is one part. And then you get the most expensive ones, and that is sable hair. Sable hair is actually the best. This comes from the tails of the saber. And it is so made that the reservoir in the point will always be in the right position. So the hairs always come back after you use it. These can be very pricey, especially if you take the Polinsky brushes. When you start watercolor painting, I should not advise you to buy these things immediately, because they can go up in quite a price. So that is not what you should use. Okay, then another thing, of course, because without, you can play with water, but not with color. That is a good watercolor box. Also, that you can buy in different price classes. Of course, it has to do with the vibrancy and the steadiness of the colors. And you have all kinds of different companies who make them. But to have a box like this, you don't have to take so many, because you don't use them all. And another thing is, of course, you have to have a steady cup to put your water in. After a while, that's your extra water, especially if you go outside. You can't easily get clean water. After a while, it gets, of course, colored, your water, and it can also disturb the brightness of the color, so you have to refill it with clean water. But a steady cup is important to take. And then, at the last moment, the last thing is a scrap of paper. Just ordinary paper. Because if you mix your colors on the palette, you never know what is inside the brush. So it can be too colorful or not enough. So it's always good if you mix your colors on the palette that you will look first, what is the strength of the color?